In the latest migration and development brief, we report on remittance trends, as well as for the first time we report new data on recruitment costs as well as on return migration. Remittances flowing to developing countries are going to rebound after two consecutive years of decline. They would rise by about 4.5% in 2017 to reach $450 billion. This welcome rebound comes on the back of recovery in economy in the United States and also relative recovery in Europe as well as in Russia. And in the case of Europe and Russia, where remittances are sourced either in euro terms or in ruble terms, exchange rate movements against the US dollar also has an important impact on the rise of flows. So the cost of sending money remains at about 7.2%, significantly higher than the sustainable development goal of 3%. And the reason for that, de-risking behavior by commercial banks that act as correspondent banks to money transfer companies, because of the worry about money laundering and association of remittances with financing of terrorism, a lot of commercial banks are refusing bank accounts for remittance companies, and even they don't want to act as correspondent banks. And that issue can be addressed by recognizing that small remittances are not really money laundering. And if we take that mindset, then we might be able to then relax the money laundering regulations and their implementation. That would then allow a lot of entry of new players with modern technology, mobile phone technology, or virtual currencies, and internet-based technologies to apply to remittance markets, and that would increase market competition and reduce costs. The report highlights the issue of high recruitment costs, which is a major barrier to promoting safe, orderly, and regular migration, another sustainable development goal. And it reports that in some corridors, for example, Pakistan to Saudi Arabia, the recruitment cost paid by a migrant worker, typically a low-skilled migrant worker, let's say working in the construction sector in Saudi Arabia, can be as high as 20 months of expected wages. It can be as high as $5,000 or $7,000. And that then makes the person, the worker, a modern-day slave in the country where the person is working. It becomes a major burden for them for 2 to 3 years of their working life, because they have to send money home just to pay back the recruitment costs. Better monitoring of recruitment practices and better enforcement of regulations to monitor recruitment practices, that would go a long ways in reducing recruitment costs. Also, we need better coordination between origin countries and destination country governments in monitoring recruitment practices. In a special section, the Migration and Development Brief reports on return migration, which is a major phenomenon this year, because a large number of asylum applications have actually been rejected, and that has added a pool of people to the pool of return migrants. The stock of people who have been detected to be undocumented has risen significantly in the last 3 years in the United States and in Europe. But return migration is not only a phenomenon for these two parts of the world, it is truly a worldwide phenomenon. Return migration is quite widely prevalent in Saudi Arabia, South Africa, or in South Korea, for example. Voluntary return is welcome and can be promoted if the migrants are better integrated in the host country, if their skills are better recognized in the host country. Portability of social security benefits can help quite a lot in this process as well. So that's the report.